Hi, I'm Achal. Welcome to another course preview of Uvdesk ticketing system. Now, configure the mailbox of your organization with Uvdesk Helpdesk so that all your incoming and outgoing emails can be converted into the tickets. And you can manage all your customer queries with a single ticket system. So, let's have a detailed discussion regarding the mailbox settings functionality of Uvdesk Helpdesk. Here, we will be checking out how to create different email templates, how to configure the SwiftMailer and Mailbox, and how to manage the spam settings of Uvdesk. So, let me take you to the backend configuration of Uvdesk Helpdesk. Now, as you can see, I am on the backend of Uvdesk Helpdesk, and here you will find the Mailbox settings on the bottom of your Helpdesk dashboard. As you can see, we are having this option of settings, and inside the settings option, you will get all the mailbox configuration settings. As you can see, we are having different settings inside this particular function, that is email setting, email template you can create from here. You can configure the mailbox and SwiftMailer as well, and also you can mark any of the email address as spam. So, let's have a discussion over each of them one by one. The very first option you are having is SwiftMailer, and first you have to configure the SwiftMailer. Basically, the SwiftMailer is used to send your emails so that your customers will get notified once you have reverted over any of the ticket. As you can see, once you tap over the SwiftMailer configuration, then it will redirect you to a new page from where you can create multiple configurations. As you can see, we have already created one of the SwiftMailer configuration, and now I am going to create a new one. You just need to tap over the create configuration, and accordingly you will get a new window. As here you can see, the very first option is mailer ID. You can add any of the mailer ID, or you can also leave it blank because it is automatically created a mailer ID for your SwiftMailer identification. So if you want, then you can mention the mailer ID over here. As I am not adding any of the mailer ID, it will auto fetch the particular ID. The next option is you are having the mailbox like the services which you are using for your mailbox, like Gmail, Yahoo, and SMTP is basically used for any of the mail service which you are using. So here I am selecting the Gmail because I am configuring the Gmail mailbox service. Once you select the transport type from the drop down, then you will get next option of enable delivery. You can active this particular option so that SwiftMailer will work accordingly. Now, the next option you are having is email address. As here, I am adding an email address, and the next option you will get is password. Password is something like, this is not the password of your mailbox, this is something the create app password. You need to mention the app password over here. You will get the link in the description box, like from where you will get to know like how you can create the app password and how you can check like how you can use that particular app password into your mailbox configurations. And you will get this app password settings inside the Google account of your Gmail, and after that you need to navigate into the security, from where you can create the new app password, and that password you need to add over here at the time of configuration. I am adding here that password. After filling out the required information, you need to tap over the save changes, and accordingly your mailer configuration is successfully saved, and you can see SwiftMailer ID is automatically generated. Now, coming next, we are having an option of spam settings. Moving ahead, I will going to show you what is spam settings. From here, you can add any of the particular email address as blacklist or whitelist. If you want to mark any of your email address as blacklist, then you can do the same. Also, you can add multiple email addresses. As here, I am going to show you how you can add multiple email address at a time. As you can see, I have added these two email addresses inside the blacklist. Now, after that, I am going to hit over the save changes button. And you can see spam settings saved successfully. So, this way you can manage all of your spam email addresses. Now, coming next, we are having an option of mailbox. From here, you can configure the mailbox. As you can see, I have already configured one of the mailbox. Now, I am going to add a new mailbox over here. The very first option is mailer ID. If you want, then you can add the same, or it will automatically generate a new mailer ID. Now here you need to provide a name to your mailbox, and from here you can active this mailbox. If you want to enable or disable, then you can use this button for the same. And next option you are having is permanently delete from inbox. If you want to delete the inbox emails, then you can choose this particular option as active or inactive as per your own convenient. Now, next we are having an option of incoming mail, means IMAP server. You need to configure your IMAP settings in order to fetch the new mail from your mailbox. As from the next option, you can select the mail service which you are using. As we have selected the Gmail, so I am going to choose the transport type as Gmail. And next option, you are having the username and email address. So here I am adding that email address, and here you need to add that particular same app password option. Like app password, you need to add over here, which we have also done inside the SwiftMailer configurations. And the next option you are having is outgoing mail, means SMTP server. The SwiftMailer you need to select over here, which is used for sending emails through your account. After that, you will get an option to select a SwiftMailer. As we have created this one, so I am selecting this SwiftMailer over here. And after that, you need to tap over the create mailbox. And you can see you have successfully configured another mailbox inside your mailbox settings. Now, coming next, we are having an option of email templates. As you can see, we have created lots of email template. Email template is basically used to send email format to your customers. If you want to create new template, then you need to hit over the new template option. And the very first option here, you will get, you need to provide a name to your email template. As here, I am creating a new template. And from here, if you want to provide any of the particular subject, then you can do the same. And if you want to add any placeholder as well, as here, I am selecting the ticket ID as a subject. It will automatically fetch that particular ticket ID to which customer you are sending the email format. And template for ticket or users, then you can select the same from here. And next, you will get an option of, if you want to provide any content, then you can add the same content over here. As here, I have provided a content. And also, you can able to add the placeholder from here. As you can see, if you want to add any like any of the placeholder before that email format, before that content, then you just need to select the same from here, as we are having multiple placeholders option. Now, after that, you need to tap over the save changes button, and automatically your email template is created successfully. And you can able to fetch the same from the list of your email templates. As you can see, we have created this one. So this way you can able to manage your email templates. Now, coming next, we are having an option of email settings. As you can see, once you tap over the email settings option, it will redirect you to a new page from where you can find the required information. Like here, you need to add over here the email ID. This is something which you can add as the email address and which is used at the time of sending the emails to your customers. As here, I have added this email address, and from here you can provide a name, as I have provided here the Uvdesk demo. And the next option is you can select the SwiftMailer from the drop down, as I have selected this one. After filling out the information, you need to tap over the proceed button and you can see email settings successfully updated. So this way you can able to manage all your mailbox configuration settings from the backend of Uvdesk Helpdesk. So that's all about the mailbox configuration of Uvdesk Helpdesk. In our upcoming videos, we will explore more features of Uvdesk ticketing system. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.